Welcome to Savvy IT Solutions. In this video, we are discussing about control structures, switch case. In the selection base, the second part, already we finished decision making. Now we are moving into selection base, that is switch case. Okay. So in this topic, we are discussing about introduction, selection base and switch case. Second one is switch case syntax, and the third one is write a Java program to read a digit 0 to 9 and print in Word, and write a Java program to read a digit 0 to 6 and print a day of the week, and write a Java program to read a digit 1 to 12 and print month, name of the month. Okay, now let them move one by one. Introduction to selection based. Previously, decision making means if it is true, we move this, we execute these statements. If it is false, then execute other statements. But in the selection based, already the selection objectives are predefined. So we need to send one value to them. It matches that argument automatically. It matches the value automatically. The respective statements will be executed. That is exactly the selection based. Means selection means already existing things, we need to select, pick one thing from the list of selector list. Okay, before discussing about the syntax, we need to know so only one thing, that is switch case. Before discussing about this, we need to understand exactly how the switch case is working. So I will explain you few examples that clearly gives the basic idea about switch case. The first situation is when you are entering into the restaurant, after seated, initially they will provide a menu to you. That menu is nothing but a switch case. Okay, so the items are placed 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, so on. So now the task comes, you ordered the fourth item, then they will serve only the fourth item, no other 1, 2, 3 and 5 will not be served. Okay, keep it in mind that they will not serve 4 and 5, only they serve 4. That is one thing. Okay, why? Because I am stressing you, these things can be implemented in switch case very seriously. Okay, this is the situation 1. Now go to situation 2. In this situation, we already again that one thing, I need to buy new iPhone 11 128 GB internal memory. We fixed that this is the mobile and this is the configuration I need to require, but go for a shop, mobile shop, and we ask about this specific requirement that is not available. Then we find that by default that is not available in that store, so we go for another store, but we cannot compromise and we need to buy. This is also happened in switch case by default. Okay, now I am moving into the syntax. So the syntax is switch expression. The expression means the value we need to pass. If that value, that expression is meet with value 1, value 2, value 3, value 4, value 5, so on. Okay, the respective statements will be executed. That is what exactly it means. Okay, now if this expression is not meet with the value 1, value 2, value 3, so on, value 5, then the default statement will be executed. This is the second example what I taken into account. If not match the expression value two values, or by default the default value will be executed. And in the first point the menu will be available. If that expression is made, the expression value meets the value, the respective statements will be executed. After that, we are using the break. Break is to terminate from the block of the statement. Block means in between what are the statements available, this statement is called a block. And we are terminating from block means no other cases will be executed. This is what exactly the switch case. I think you understand very clearly. Now I will explain the flow chart. So here this is the expression. This expression 1 is equal to value 1, then statements 1 will be executed. Okay, similarly this is equal to value 2, then statements 2 will be executed. This is equal to value 3, then statements 3 will be executed, and so on. Finally is default, then statements. These are connected to a connector. This is the way the expression will be executed. Okay, this is the flow chart representation of a switch case. Now we are moving to write a Java program to read a digit 0 to 9 and print in words. So simple thing, 0 ZERO, 1 ONE, 2 TWO, similarly 9 NINE. So what I need to do, I need one number, that number is N. I send to switch case, so case 0, okay, system dot out dot println 0. Okay, so for the space constraint I will write break here. Similarly case 1, system dot out dot println 1, break. Similarly case 2, system dot out dot println 2 and break, so on. While writing the program I will write all the cases, but here when explaining it I will ignore some cases due to time constraint. Okay, 9 system dot out dot println 9 break. Other than this we need to write default invalid choice. This is the way we are representing this program. Now write a Java program to read a digit 0 to 6 and print day of the week. So similarly previous thing, switch N case 0. Here I need to mention one thing, 0 for Sunday, 1 for Monday, and so on, 6 for Saturday. Okay, case 0, system dot out dot println, send a break. Case one, system dot out dot println Monday break. Similarly, case 6, system dot out dot println Saturday and break. Okay, so finally default condition invalid choice, system dot out dot println invalid choice. This is the way the representation of a day of the week. Now the last program, write a Java program to read a digit 1 to 12 and print the name of the month. So similar example, there is no change, switch n case 1 Jan break, case 2 February break, so on. Case 11 November break, case 12 default invalid choice. This is the way we are representing switch case. Okay, these three programs are explained in the next session with practically. Apart from this, we are also discussing few more programs of simply if else programs of what we discussed previously are implemented in this scenario in more detail. Thank you.